There's an example I ran into on an expedition in Ethiopia. I was a plant collector, but I really had a strong interest in finding out how the native people we were running into used these plants. And they were people very attached to the land. They lived by the spear for the most part. They hunted, and some of them were warrior tribes, but most of the tribes we ran into were not. And they were very remote. The Ethiopian government, when they gave us permission to explore the Omo River, had a request, which was, tell us who's there, because we've never been there. Mm-hmm. We don't know if anyone's living along that river. We suspect they are, because we sent some troops down there once and they never came back. And that's the other thing. Find out what happened to the 200 troops we sent there. So we found the tribe that killed the troops, and because they were asking these native people living close to the land for taxes. They were going to have to pay annual taxes to the government. This is when it was a communist government in the 70s and 80s. But anyway, identifying all these plants, our job was to float down the Omo River for 400 miles or so and identify what was there, the habitats, habitat types, and plants, and how the native people had an economy. The Ethiopian government didn't know who was there, but also wanted to know, what's their economy? What do they do there? Are they wild? So these people were actually living a life very similar to the Native Americans before white men showed up. They had bows and arrows and spears, and they hunted the wildlife, and they collected a lot of plants, and they had a tremendous wealth of information about medicines from plants that we learned just in the course of interviewing them. The more I asked questions through our interpreter, the more I was fascinated. One of the plants they had was elephant tree, which is related to two of our plants we have in Sinx Canyon here just down the hill. Dogbane, which is in the milkweed family, and milkweed, common milkweed. But we didn't really know that at the time. I identified the plant as being in the milkweed family because of the type of flower and fruit it had. But I didn't really know tropical plants that well. So I took it back to the botanist, who was my boss, and said, I'm pretty sure this is an asclepius in the family of milkweed. And I did a little test on myself to prove it, and I showed him a birthmark I had that was kind of a growth that stuck out a little bit in black. And I said, I broke a branch and this white latex came out, which is one of the characteristics of milkweed family, only this was a tree. It didn't look anything like milkweed. And I put a drop on that growth, and by the time I ran back to camp here, which was an hour or so, it has come off. It's just sitting there on my skin now. I pulled it off and showed it to him. I said, so it has a proteolytic enzyme. It dissolved this thing away, and that's a characteristic of milkweed. They were used by Native Americans as a meat tenderizer. You could pound it in the meat to tenderize it. You could put it on a wart and make it go away. It would dissolve it away. If you used it with gumweed, it would never come back. They knew all of these things. And dogbane was used, the relative of milkweed that grows around Lander and, well, most canyons around Wyoming. Was used to slow down the heart rate and increase the amplitude of the heart, so it was used to recover from heart attacks. So those are the diverse things that were used by this sap of the milkweed family in the United States, or in North America. So we, through the interpreter, interviewed one of the medicine people in the tribe, the Mursi tribe, and we asked them what they did with elephant tree. Showed them the tree, and they had their own name for it. And there were three things they did with it. They used it as a meat tenderizer. they used it for people who were recovering from heart problems. And was used to remove warts and ugly skin deformities. So those are plants that don't look like each other, but the chemical elements, the chemical principles inside of these diverse plants were known to the native people for probably thousands of years.